I'm a little bit nervous because I'm not used to holding these kind of snakes, even though I'm told this guy is not poisonous. Vodka with snake blood. Huge, huge facility and some big, big cobras.
In the heart of Hanoi lies a suburb where the past and present meld in the most extraordinary fashion. Here, snakes, predominantly cobras, are not merely revered, they are the cornerstone of a trade steeped in centuries of tradition. A trade that is as dangerous as it is vital. Encompassing food, alcohol, and medicine, this village embodies the profound influence of Chinese culture on Hanoian cuisine, a testament to a unique dish that commands an astonishing demand.
The crazy thing about this suburb is that it just looks like any normal suburb in Hanoi, but then many of these houses, these restaurants of sorts, they house hundreds and hundreds of snakes. Cobras, green snakes, brown snakes. They cook them, they turn them into rice wine, they do those crazy beating heart shots that Anthony Bourdain did on his trip to Vietnam. Lem Mat Snake Village is pretty crazy.
Nestled in the heart of the ever-expanding Hanoi, Lem Mat transitions seamlessly from a village into a vibrant suburb, its roots deeply intertwined with centuries-old snake traditions. The epicenter of this industry are three powerful families, proprietors of large restaurants specializing in exotic foods, with a spotlight on their renowned snake dishes.
Right now, this place seems kind of empty, but I get the vibe it's the calm before the storm. The amount of seating here is huge.
Today, we start out at one of them, Wok Fung, a sprawling establishment where culinary adventure awaits, starting with the visit to their nearby snake farm.
So that bad boy right behind me is a huge cobra, probably the biggest cobra I've ever seen. And the caretaker here is seriously comfortable with snakes. I mean, just wild. Huge, huge facility and some big, big cobras. This is the farm that supplies probably the largest snake restaurant in Vietnam. I'm a little bit nervous because I'm not used to holding these kind of snakes, even though I'm told this guy is not poisonous. But this is just one of many, many snake families here in this district. This entire village is dedicated to farming snakes for eating. I'm gonna put this bad boy down. I've seen this kind of restaurant before, but only deep in the countryside. The restaurant is absolutely massive. Just the sheer ability to feed that many people, very impressive. There's not too many other places like this in all of Vietnam.
Le Mat's history is steeped in legend, where a local hero once saved a princess from a giant water serpent, cementing a centuries-old bond with snakes. This tale is vividly celebrated during the annual Snake Festival, a vibrant event that encapsulates the village's rich heritage and unity, featuring snake dances and rituals that pay homage to their heroic ancestor. Back at Wok Fung, I opt for a simple green snake. It will be turned into three dishes. At this unique dining experience, the heart and liver of the snake are to be paired with vodka, showcasing the traditional medical beliefs of the region.
This looks kind of disgusting, but Bourdain did it, so surely I'm allowed to. Okay, so basically this is vodka mixed with snake blood with the heart placed inside of it. It's like probably one of the more gory shots I've ever had, and I'm not really looking forward to the vodka shot at like 11 a.m. anyway. Okay, cheers, bottoms up, guys. I don't know. It's about as good as you expect it to be. Hopefully the meal tastes a little bit better than that. Maybe it'll make it easier to eat. So that's the snake blood, which is mixed in with the vodka. And here, this green stuff, which I've just never seen, is apparently the snake liver. When I ate the turtle in Australia, it also had a green liver. So, I mean, maybe it's a reptile thing. Just so gross. I mean, who's ever had like a green body part before? All right, let's have a go. Oh, yeah, that's horrible. That is really horrible. It's got like a real bitter, bitter aftertaste to it. Let's hope that the rest of this meal is way better than that.
It's a practice believed by some to have numerous health benefits, and I'm not too sure about that. But but at least nothing's going to waste. The heart of Wok Phung is a bustling kitchen. It's split in half with a wet section dedicated to slaughtering and butchering, situated right in the heart of the restaurant.
Behind me there's a sort of butchery section of the restaurant, and there's a snake just sitting on the ground waiting its turn quite patiently. Not something you see at every restaurant, that's for sure.
The atmosphere here is electrifying, with orders being announced over megaphone and a team of adept cooks swiftly preparing a vast array of dishes. It's a somewhat chaotic scene, something you'd be hard-pressed to find anywhere else, with snakes being extracted from bags right next to cooking stations.
This restaurant is kind of chaos, I've got to admit. There's birds hanging from the wall, a whole bunch of woks going, guys calling out orders on megaphones. It's just complete madness. I kind of like it, kind of fun. My kind of restaurant.
On today's menu is sauteed snake meat paired with mushroom, fried snake bones, and a serving of crispy snake skin.
All of these dishes are something that I've never tried before. I've had snake once before with the mom in Northern Laos with Sunny, and I'm pretty sure that got completely cut out of the shoot. And to be honest, that was absolutely horrible. So it'd be hard for this to taste any worse. And this certainly is that. I mean, it's not every day you get to eat snake. Let's dive right in. I'm most interested in the meat. I think this has the best chance of just being pretty good. So let's try it out. It's actually way firmer than I thought it would be. Chewier than fish, lighter than chicken, and it's right there in the middle. Actually quite good. None of the bones are in this at all. You can just eat the meat. I sort of thought it would be maybe like fish where you're trying to dodge bones here and there, but not at all. It looks like they were able to separate the meat completely from the bones and from the skin. So super easy to eat. Hey, but that dish is just really, really good. Super solid. Okay, let's try a little bit of these snake bones, because this is kind of a little bit crazy. The last time I had snake, it was actually the meat and the bones were all just chopped up into one, into sort of snake cakes. And that was especially not very good because of the bones. So in this dish, they've completely separated the bones and they've turned into what looks like just like a red powder almost. I can't imagine it's very good. I haven't eaten too many bones before, but I just thought that is an exceptional dish. But maybe this one's different. Let's check it out. You eat it with a little bit of rice cracker. So maybe that'll hide some of the bone crunch. This is just like a big scoop of snake bones. Oh wow, crunchy. Oh my God, it's kind of hard to taste. Crunchy, battered, lemongrassy something. It's almost like a seasoning you would find on chips, but way more crunchy. Really an odd dish, I've got to admit. Okay, finally, the snake skin. Probably the thing that resembles snake the most still. It's got a complete white color, which is kind of interesting. A white gray, because the snake was actually kind of a beautiful green and gold. Let's check it out. Well, really not much flavor at all. Almost like a less crunchy rice cracker, something without the sesame seeds in it. Almost the exact texture and flavor of one of those really airy rice crackers. But yeah, the meat is quite excellent and I think clearly the star of the show.
But the culinary journey in Lamat extends beyond the dining table. In the corners of Lamat, microbreweries are busy crafting rice wine, not merely as beverages, but as a medium to preserve snakes, a sight that might be disturbing for some. While the purported health benefits might raise an eyebrow, the commitment and earnestness of the brewers here cannot be denied. It's a tradition that has been practiced for centuries and I'm glad that it's being kept alive.
Oh, oh wow, it's actually pretty good. That's really weird. It's got like a cherry in it or something, huh? Who makes the wine? Do you make the wine? There, are there still a lot of people in this village that make the snake wine?
Ví dụ khách người ta vào nhà nào thì người ta uống một uống cảm thấy mà thích thì người ta quay lại. Nếu mà về rượu rắn thì người Trung Quốc là hay là Đài Loan là người ta vẫn là thích nhất.
Thank you for letting me try some of this wine. It was really good stuff. Honestly, some of the best rice wine I've had in country, which is kind of crazy. Usually it's horrible. This stuff was really great.
Personally, I'm not a fan of rice wine at all, But I found this surprisingly palatable, especially given the strong concentration needed to preserve the snake. I think it's made in a far more artisanal way here than in some of the other areas of the countryside. To understand more, I sit down with Wok, part of the family that owns the large Wok Fung Jai restaurant.
Okay. Wok, how long has your family had this restaurant here for?
Nhà hàng bên em thì mở được 15 năm.
Why is it so popular to eat snakes here?
Bởi vì là bên em là rắn là nghề của làng lâu năm rồi. Cái nghề nuôi rắn thì là nuôi sống dân ở làng lại mà.
And what is it about snakes? Why do people like eating snakes? Is it good for your health? Are there other benefits?
Thịt rắn thì có nhiều chất, rất nhiều đạm, là bổ cho xương cốt này. Và còn ngoài ra thì mình dùng được cả tiết rắn và mật rắn. Mật rắn thì cũng tốt cho chức năng tiêu hóa, mọi độ tuổi đều dùng được thịt rắn. Còn rượu rắn thì người cao tuổi một chút thì dùng tốt hơn. Thường thì nếu mà như thế thì người trung tuổi thì lựa chọn ăn thịt rắn nhiều hơn là giới trẻ.
How many types of snake do you sell here?
Ở nhà hàng thì bán 3 loại chính là rắn hổ mang, rắn giáo châu và rắn giáo ta, dòng hổ mang. Mang thì là có giá trị cao nhất.
Where do you get all your snakes from? Are they all from your farm or do you order from outside as well?
Ở trên các vùng cao.
In this entire village, how many families are still involved in the snake business?
Khoảng những hộ lớn thì có khoảng 5 hộ nữa. Họ nuôi cũng để cung cấp rắn và có trang trại của nhà hàng mình thì là lớn nhất ở đây.
And what do you think the future is for this village? Do you think that it will continue to be about snake farming or do you think that things will change?
Nó vẫn sẽ phát triển được. Chính quyền với địa phương cũng tạo điều kiện để phát triển khu nuôi rắn.
Okay, thank you for letting me know a little bit about this village. Guys, that is it for this one. I have once again forgotten to record an outro from location. So I'm coming to you from my studio, since it's raining outside, to say thanks for watching. And if you enjoyed this content, please consider subscribing. Maybe even give me a like. I'd appreciate it. Anyway, thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.